Hello, and welcome to Miaville News. In today's top story, local squirrels are making a nutty choice. Researchers find 85% of our furry friends prefer acorns over walnuts. Who knew squirrels could be such tough food critics? In other news, a group of students are delving into the world of percents. Using visual models and relatable daily examples, these students are making math fun and accessible. And now, your local weather. Tomorrow's forecast hints at a sprinkle of winter's charm. We're looking at a 10% chance of snow flurries. Expect highs of 30 and lows near 24 degrees Fahrenheit. With winds moving through at about 8 miles per hour, we're in for a chilly day ahead. Remember to wear layers and stay warm out there, everybody.
Hey, Mia, come check it out. The weather report says there's going to be a 10% chance of snow tomorrow. Mia? Whoa, someone's ready for a snow day. You've already got your sled out and everything. But the weather reporter said there was a 10% chance of snow. So is it going to snow or not? What do you think? With a 10% chance of snow, will Mia be able to hit the slopes with her sled tomorrow? Pause here to jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. I know that a chance of snow means it might snow, but also that it might not. So we need to figure out if 10% is a good chance. But what exactly is a percent? A percentage is a part of a whole expressed out of 100. Part of a whole. Where have we heard that before? Of course, fractions and decimals. So percentages are another way to represent part of a whole, but in percentages, the whole is always 100. For example, if there were 100 squirrels, and 85 of them loved acorns, then we could say 85% of the squirrels love acorns. When writing a percentage, we use the percent symbol. It stands for out of 100. So let's say out of our 100 squirrels, 15 of them love walnuts. How could that be written as a percentage? Well, 15 out of 100 love walnuts, so we can use the percent symbol, 15%. Visual models can be super helpful when trying to understand new math concepts. To visually represent percentages, we can use a grid, like this one, which is sectioned into 100 little squares. Remember, percent means out of 100, so if we wanted to use this grid to show 85%, how many squares would need to be shaded in? 85% means 85 out of 100, so we would shade in 85 squares. If we imagine that each one of these tiny squares represents one squirrel, this model makes it clear that most of the squirrels love acorns. How about this grid? It has 50 little squares out of 100 colored in. What percentage does that represent? 50%. Now you try it. Pause here to shade the grids in your guided notes to represent 25% and 10%. 25% means 25 out of 100, so we should shade in 25 squares. And for 10%, we would shade in 10 squares. The meteorologist from the newscast said there was a 10% chance of snow. Does that mean it's a good chance it'll snow or not? We just shaded one of these grids to show 10%, and based on the grid, 10% doesn't seem like very much. But how does this help us understand what a 10% chance of snow means? Maybe if we think about other places we've seen percentages, we can figure this out. Can you think of a time where you've heard or seen percentages? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. Maybe in a store when something was 25, 50, or 75% off? On a weather report? Or maybe the device you're watching this video on right now tells you how much charge the battery has as a percentage. Oh, great idea, Mia. To help you get a feel for the information we can learn from percentages, Mia is going to show us some different scenarios, and we get to decide what percentage would best fit that situation. Okay, scenario number one. Mia is playing Dragon Race on Miacademy. Fun. Uh-oh, her computer battery is low. What percentage could Mia's computer battery be showing? Could it be at 93%, 64%, or 13%? Pause here if you want to take some time to think. Means 93 out of 100. And based on this visual model, we could tell that the battery would be near a full charge. 64% is a little above half, so she probably wouldn't get a low battery notification at 64%. 13%, or 13 out of 100, is pretty close to zero. So if Mia's computer's battery is low, then from these options, her computer battery could be at 13%. Get ready for scenario number two. And this time, if you want to use the 100 square grids to help you, there's a page of extra grids that you can use in your PDF. Mia is shopping for a brand new sled. Both sleds cost $20, but good news, they're on sale. The red sled is 60% off, and the green sled is 40% off. Which sled has the better discount? Pause here to record your thoughts in your guided notes. The red sled is 60% off, which is more than 40%. Because it has a higher discount, Mia would be saving more money. Nice work. Last scenario. Mia is planning a trip to the beach. On Saturday, there's a 100% chance of rain. On Sunday, there's a 30% chance of rain. If Mia wants to enjoy the beach without rain, which day may be the better option? Pause here to record your answer in your guided notes. There's a 100% chance of rain on Saturday, which means it's definitely going to rain. On Sunday, there's a 30% chance of rain, which means it might rain on Sunday, but it's a lot less likely than on Saturday. So, back to our original question. The meteorologist said there was a 10% chance of snow tomorrow. What do you think? Now that we have a better understanding of what percentages are, do you think it will snow so Mia can go sledding? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. 10 out of 100 just isn't very much. It's much closer to zero than it is to 100, which means the chances of snow are pretty low. It might snow, but it's not very likely. I'm sorry, Mia. I think you and your sled will have to wait until another possible snow day comes around.
This just in, our previous snow predictions were way off. Folks, we're looking at a 90% chance of snow tomorrow, so go ahead and dig those sleds out of the closet because chances are looking pretty good for some winter fun out there.
I guess Mia and I have some snow prepping to do. Be sure to complete the PDF activities and practice questions that go along with this lesson, and keep an eye out for more percentages. You may just find that they pop up more than you think. Keep crunching those numbers, mathematicians, and I'll see you next time. Hey.